From the new dungeon to Old Gambit, here are 15 and a half things in Destiny 2 that you might not know. Powerful Attraction is a new armor mod added to the season. On paper, it's supposed to simply automatically collect any nearby orbs of power when you activate your class ability. Personally, I find this to be mostly useless and needless. But this works for more than just orbs. When in Gambit, you can use this to collect all nearby motes, which, in a game all about collecting and banking copious amounts of motes, this is very helpful. Shout out to SoyDoom for showing me this one on our Discord. Cerberus is a weird gun. But a subtle detail that you might not have noticed about it is that when you ADS, you can actually see the next pattern of bullets it's going to spray while you're in the sights. You might not even notice because of the amount of flash, but it's kind of neat, little subtle detail. Enjoying the new Ghost of the Deep dungeon? Then I have a tip and a warning to give you. First off, you can use your dive abilities like Shatter Dive, Phoenix Dive, Quick Fall, etc. to quickly get from a diving point above the methane liquid, water, stuff, to a point below it much quicker, just for a little bit of speedrun tech. But be careful when doing this when you dive over a pit that has one of those upward currents, because the force applied to your body is greater than the force applied from the dive, and this could lock you into an indefinite period of animation dive where you'll just have to eventually change your subclass in order to break out or enjoy getting shot at like some weird version of Duck Hunt. This next one has been around for a while, but it's starting to see a bit of a resurgence. Did you know that you can duplicate threadlings from your threadling grenade by simply throwing it into a movable or destructible world object, such as these breakable pieces of cover around Neomuna? God only knows what shenanigans this could cause, but because this has been in the game since Lightfall's launch, it's possible this might not get patched out. Hopefully I don't end up eating my words on that. Before we continue, remember to subscribe. Many of you watch a lot of our videos but aren't actually subscribed. I appreciate it. Trying to get enough pieces of gear for your Iron Banner reputation bonus? Some of you may know that you can transmog your gear to get the bonus, just simply taking any normal piece of gear and giving it an Iron Banner transmog will do it. But did you know that if you take an already Iron Banner armor and apply another Iron Banner transmog on top of it, you will get two bonuses for one piece of armor, and this can be very handy. Some of you might not have known that Bungie is using the Shire's Wrath to experiment with this new reticle system that we are seeing here. This system shows your weapon's accuracy cones as you fire. This also came right behind another change which I haven't seen many players mention, which allows you to change what color your reticle changes to when you hover over an enemy, and this can add a nice little splash of customization or accessibility if you so need it. This one's really neat and I haven't seen a lot of people mention it. Did you know that you can emote next to a freshly ranked up guardian in the tower to gain a sort of mock-up version of the speed boost and jump boost that they receive? Next time you see someone get that shining gold ore from their rank up, offer them a high five to have a little bit of fun yourself. Now that you have this bonus, it's time to combine it with the Flora's Lava Challenge buff to gain even more jump height and speed. Yes, this is completely useless, but hey, it's pretty funny. To my knowledge, there are no other exotics in the game named explicitly after an interactable NPC, except for the Helm of Saint 14. And as a fun little secret, Bungie coded a custom dialogue possibility if you're wearing his legendary helmet while approaching him.
I will look after the people, friend. They will be safe while you do your work. You look like me. Let us confuse Zavala like this.
Sword hilts seem to be bugging again. If you're a hunter using combination blows with a heavy-handed armor mod for your gauntlets, getting a sword hilt kill with that melee buff active will generate orbs of power. I've also been told that this works for any arc damage objects you pick up, such as the wrenches in the current season, so give it a try and let me know. Perhaps what may be worse, though, is that our good old friend the Syntheseps seem to be dealing bonus damage with sword hilts again. Simply get the surrounded bonus damage from the biotic enhancements and watch your damage spike for really no good reason. Hopefully this doesn't end up breaking the game again, but if it's one thing that the Destiny community is good at, it's breaking this game over its knee. This is a subtle bug that I think could be pretty helpful in the right context. Using your jump immediately into your Strand Hunter Silk Strike super animation will send you way higher than it's probably intended to. And as an added bonus, you can also continuously use your overhead spin to keep yourself in the air. It's expensive, but it could be a handy way to skip over a gap or jumping puzzle, especially with your two grapple abilities at your disposal. Fallout posted a video about this one, but it's way too good not to include here. Titans, your frag grenades that bounce off the ground and off of objects, such as incendiary grenades, flashbangs, and suppressors, will go straight through your barricades. Meaning, if you have a barricade up, you can suppress a target, for example, without having to worry about getting shot. Interestingly, this doesn't seem to work from the rock grenade from the Forerunner's exotic catalyst, despite the obvious similarities. My best guess is that this is somehow caused by the new Arbor Warden exotic chest piece, but who knows? Let's end this list with a silly one. If you have two Arc Striders on the opposite team, you can theoretically bounce a projectile between them so long as their super lasts. This is fine, but it's particularly funny with the Gathering Storm super, which can also be reflected. Subscribe or I'll unpop your knuckles. Bless your faces and deuces.